The governor of Quirino Province, Dakila Carlo Cua, now joins us on the line for his thoughts on the Duterte administration's measures against the new coronavirus disease. Governor Dax Cua is also the president of the Union of Local Authorities of the Philippines and the chairman of the National League of the Provinces of the Philippines. Good morning, Governor Dax, and thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Christian, and everybody who is listening.
Okay.
Yes.
The president last night said that he was inclined to extend the community quarantine in Luzon for a couple of more weeks until the end of April. Is there a stand coming from ULA, for example, regarding this possible extension? Are you in favor of this?
Yes. Together with the president, we agree that ang prioridad ngayon ay ang kalusugan ng bawat mamamayan. We will support the decision of the IATF. It's inspiring that they are all working so hard, risking their health for the people. No? Recommendations lang naman ng ating ULAP ay una, sana magkaroon ng ayuda sa ating mga local government units. Each local government unit kasi ay may role in this quarantine. Andiyan ang mga barangay na nag-aayos ng ating home quarantine. Andiyan po ang mga mayor na nagpapatakbo ng kalakal. Andiyan din naman po ang mga gobernador na nagpapatakbo ng mga ospital at ng healthcare systems. So every LGU has a role in this, and every LGU are finding difficulties in terms of funding and resources.
Regarding the funding and resources, for example, there's this thing called Social Amelioration Program. But we are hearing a lot of issues coming from different local governments regarding the actual number that should receive, the number of households that should receive. So what's the situation there, for example, in Quirino? Is there really a disparity when it comes to the number of cards that or forms that were distributed by the DSWD and the actual number of low-income households that are supposed to receive cash aid from the national government?
Yes. Talagang magkakaroon ng discrepancy, at ako'y natutuwa na kagabi napanood natin si Presidente na sinabi niya at susubukan nilang dagdagan nito. Salamat po, Mr. President, because tulad naman ng nasabi ng ilang gobernador sa inyo, sa oras ngayon, wala pong pinipili itong problema. Middle class man o mahirap, lahat po apektado, lahat po kailangan ng ayuda. Although we do appreciate the initial response of the government of Bayanihan Act of 270 billion, malaki pong pera yon, malaki pong tulong yon. Pinasasalamatan natin yan. Pero sana madagdagan pa kasi meron pa tayong mga kababayan na apektado. Doon kasing in-identify ng DSWD ang ating mga beneficiaries o yung mga most vulnerable in the society, marami po sa ating kababayan will qualify under that. Mga single parents po, senior citizens, hindi po formally employed. So, ang dami pong pamilya na will qualify for this criteria.
Oo nga, pero ang binanggit, Governor, dun sa Bayanihan Act, 18 million low-income households. So, kumusta naman yung comparison ng actual list coming from the SWD dun sa listahan ng mga local governments? For example, in the province of Quirino, nagtutugma ba?
Yes. In the province of Quirino kasi, no, we are basically a very agricultural and rural province. No? Most of our constituents, aming mga kababayan, ay mga farmers. Marami dito mga pamilya ng OFW, marami dito mga market vendors, marami dito tricycle operators, operators of fish ponds pala. So dahil dyan, ang dami pong qualified sa amin. Kaya dahil maraming qualified, sa ngayon yung allocation ng DSWD only covers about 60 to 70% of our total households. So instead of the 80% average of the 18 million families out of the 21 million families in the Philippines, sa amin nasa 60-70% lang, hindi po umabot ng 80. So this is one of the issues that we are confronting today. And that's why, kanina po, nasabi ko na kung meron mang ayuda ang national government sa ating mga local government, malaking itutulong to. Baka pwede po natin pagtulungan, hanapan ng solusyon yung mga gaps na ng ating program.
Governor Duck, so you mentioned wala pang 80% yung percentage ng, for example, nung talaga makakatanggap pag kinumpara yung listahan, di ba, sa Quirino. So what happens, yes, to the rest of the low-income families in Quirino, assuming na hindi dumating yung tulong from the national government for those, let's say, 20 or 30% of your low-income households? Meron bang pondo or resources yung province to actually shoulder the amount for the remaining population there?
Yun nga, yung nakita natin, ano, talagang mahirap yung kung ating aasahan lang yung revenues ng local government. Kulang talaga. That's why we are explaining to our dear president na any help would go a long way. Any help would be appreciated. For example, kasi this happened in the first quarter of 2020. So in the first quarter, ang ira po kasi o ang revenue ng local government comes on a monthly basis. So yung available quick response fund namin ay ang na-release ay until the month of April pa lang. Pati yung calamity fund ng local government, pati yung 20% development fund. In fact, the whole era of the local governments have only been released up to the month of April. So kung ating kukomputin, hindi pa available yung buong expected calamity fund ng mga local government. Kaya medyo hirap din talaga ang mga LGU po.
So wala pang ilalabas, in short, na sapat na pondong LGUs. No.
Medyo ngayon, we're trying to source from our development fund and other funds. Yung iba may savings from the previous year. So, meron naman na re-remedyo. Pero kung mag-extend kasi tayo, the president spoke about the possibility of extending. And we support that. But sana paghandaan din natin dahil every extension will equate to some expenses on the part of government.
Okay, Governor Duck Skua, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you po. Good morning.